What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's your boy Prosper. How are you doing? How are you faring today? So today we're going to be talking about how to start a POS business, aka cashback business. Basically, an exchange business. You need money, I give you money, and you give me a commission. Pretty simple, pretty simple. So this is going to be falling under the series, how to make an extra source of income or how to start a business. I don't know really what to call the series, but that's basically it. So today we're going to be talking about how to make money. I personally use the POS regularly because I can't stand the excess queues at the ATM. Basically, I use the POS because it's more convenient and easier for me to use, and I'm pretty sure you too have used them once in a while. So if you want to know how to run the business, how to go into this business to make an extra income for yourself, I'm going to be breaking down the steps and tips and challenges and every single thing you need to know about this business. There's not going to be guesswork. After you watch this video, you're going to be informed fully on how this business goes. So if this interests you or you like this, please do well to drop a thumbs up on this video, subscribe, and maybe share with your friends and family. So first things first, we're going to be talking about is cost. How much does it cost to get to the ATM, your location, and running costs? So the first thing we're going to be talking about is the POS. How much does it really cost to acquire the POS? Now, there are two ways in which you can acquire the POS. Either you acquire it from your bank or third-party retailers, which are people like OP, who have license to give you POS and run financial transactions. So how much does it cost? It varies actually. For the bank, it's free. You can get it free, and there are conditions you have to meet to get it from your bank. And from third party guys, it's between 20 and 50,000. 20 and 50,000. Some say they are free, but if you read through the fine print, you'll see that you have to pay some certain amount. So through the bank, it's free. If you have an account with your bank, it's basically you go in there with your registered business name, and it's pretty simple. The customer care representative will do it for you, prepare every single thing, and within a week or two, you get your POS delivered to your business. You have a minimum requirement though. You have to be able to pull in 1 million naira, so put that in mind. Then for your third party guys, which is OP, in their fine print they say it's free. No, on the books they say it's free, but when I read through their fine print and terms of service, I discovered that you have to pay 50,000. So I'm wondering where that free comes into play. Maybe you are playing with words or something. The next thing under cost is location. How do you get your location? How much will it cost for you to get the location that will be viable? Now under location, I'm going to recommend you go to a place in which is high grossing, place in which has a high foot traffic, or a place which has a high number of people moving to successfully run this business. Because if you're in a place in which nobody sees you, you're not going to make any money. Everybody's just going to walk past you. So you need a place, either a junction or a place in which is busy, a market, a place in which like a school environment. You know those kind of places in which have high foot traffic and more eyes can see you. I don't know if you get my point. So I'm going to recommend those places. Then as for the bank are your major competition. So I'm going to recommend you go closer to strategies in businesses. Know what your competition is always doing. And basically, most people, if they can't stand the queue, they are an alternative, they go towards you. Or you can go there, it's even easier for you. You can lobby who are there. Ah, madam, chairman, how far now? You don't go like leave this queue. Ah, you know now you're a hustler. You hustle them. Or you can also You can, it's also going to save you cost of, because you're just starting, it's also going to save you cost of transportation, going to get more cash if you're starting with few funds, going to save you costs. So you can just basically walk into the bank, withdraw some cash, and come back to your business. So that is also an advantage for being closer to the bank. So, but all in all, you need to go to a place in which has a high amount of people. Basically, that's it. You need to pay for rent. Or either you rent out your place or you leverage on someone who already has a location in that vicinity. I'm going to recommend that for a start, you can leverage with someone because you don't need that much space. All you just need is your banner, your table, and your chair you're going to sit down. So, or if you basically want to run something else, you might actually attach it to your business, then you can rent out. But if you just the cash back, you can stay with someone, then pay them either a weekly fee or a monthly fee to use their space. So I'm going to say if you're renting for yourself, 200,000, 300,000. But for a start, I personally would not recommend that. You can actually lobby someone, 5,000, you can pay the person a month, 10,000. It depends on how the business is moving, how that one even gives you an out. So if within a month that place is not moving, you pack your bag and go to somewhere else. So that's an advantage of hitting that place, not being staying with someone. So you can also do that. So how much is it going to cost? Anywhere from 10,000, no, sorry, anywhere from 5,000 to 200,000. Put that in mind, quote unquote. Aside that, you're also going to need your chairs, your banner, your table, and some other equipment, maybe your fan or whatever. So roughly, I'm going to give a ballpark of, let's say, 50,000 to run all that. So under that, we've talked about the ATM between 20,000 and between 3 and 50,000. We've also talked about your location between 5k and 200,000. We've also talked about your debt costs, which has to do with your equipment and stuff, which has to do with your equipment and other miscellaneous you're going to need. That's 50,000. So we have 50 for the ATM, roughly estimate, 200k for the location, and you also have 50k for that. That's 300,000. That is on the way higher end. But if you go through some other means, bank free location, you can be paying 5,000, 5k into the business, and another between 20 and 50k. That's how much you're coming at 25 or 55,000. Chicken out. Other phones that are going to come in contact is running cost. You have to pay your local government or wherever you are that you're running your business in. You have to pay commission to them. You also have to take into consideration that every single transaction, there is a service charge in which you have to also put in mind when you're setting up your charge, because everything cannot be rosy. There are some challenges you're going to face when coming into this business, and it will not be good of me to tell you all the good side and not give the challenges to this business. So what are the challenges? Now, first thing you're going to come in contact with is bad network. I don't know, you've heard it, bad network, network issues, card money being stuck and stuff. You have to put that in mind, because it comes with the territory. Bad network is pretty much a thing. Even in the banks, they also have issues with that money hanging and stuff. So you have to put that in mind. You have to also put in mind the local government. I'm in Port Harcourt right now, Obiapo. Their issue too much. So you have to also put that in course in as a challenge. Another thing you have to put in this thing is, it's not pretty much a challenge, but it's something you have to also do. So I'll just say your service charge you're going to be coming in contact with. Another challenge you're going to be facing is the issue of electricity. We don't have that much electricity, and you need this to run. Either you're using your phone or you're using your POS, either you charge it or you charge your phone and stuff. That is also a challenge. Either you get a small gen or you get a handy power bank in which can charge these devices. If you can do that, you do that, so you stay on the safe side. Those are the challenges in this business. Are not even that hard. They're not much, but you have to also know all this, check within, and this is a business you can run within 2 weeks. If you have your cash, you can run into this business. It's pretty simple. So now, to get more information, I'm going to be dropping links down in the description. We'll be dropping list of banks in which offer the service and offer the POS. So you can go through them. There are links. I'm going to drop the links down below. So that's pretty much it. It's a very, very easy business. Not too much stress. If you have your money, you can go into it. So guys, that's been it. If this video has brought you value, please do.